Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, we're going to be diving into Whereby, which is a Zoom alternative. Obviously, there's a lot of controversy about Zoom. Today, we're going to be diving into the features of Whereby, how it works, and how you can get started, and give you a few opinions on how it works. Now, before we dive in, you can check out our full Zoom alternatives, as well as an explainer to what is happening with Zoom, available in the cards above. So do check that out, and let's dive into today's video. Okay folks, so let's start out with a few facts and figures like we normally do before diving into some of the features. So this is a video meeting tool that works in the browser. It also has a desktop and mobile applications. It apparently has a 4.7 out of 5 on the G2 crowd rating as well. Now, of course, people want to know what the pricing is like in this application. Now, they do have a free plan, which is much more suitable for personal use, and it allows one user license and one meeting room. You can add up to 4 meeting participants, which is actually a little bit larger than some of the other ones. I know that Zoom allows up to 3 in their free plan, but that's with a 40-minute limit, and there's actually no statement of limits on the Whereby site. You can also get with the free plan easy to read meeting room links, so you can create custom and unique links for your meeting rooms. Now, along with that, they state that you can get secure conversations, you can lock rooms, use the YouTube integration, and screen share inside of that free plan. Now, comparable to Zoom, I would say this is much more suitable for those who have regular meetings for freelancers and professionals rather than large-scale meetups. And the only reason behind that is because you'll be having to pay a much, much higher price than Zoom if you are looking to do something like that. I will mention the business plan near the end, but the pro plan is one user license with 3 meeting rooms, and you can have up to 12 meeting participants, branded rooms which allow you to add a custom logo with backgrounds, which is very cool. You can add recording on, but that is going to be another additional $5 per month, which allows you to record meetings, download them locally and share them, as well as premium screen sharing, which gives you more control over who's sharing things, with Trello, Google Drive and YouTube integrations as well. So that is going to be priced at $9.99 per month, which is still actually a little bit cheaper than the likes of Zoom. So we're all set up on Whereby, and it's pretty simple to get set up. All you have to do is add in your details, and you get something which is a verification login, which is very neat. You don't actually get a password, and you can actually go over to privacy, and you won't find the ability to reset your password. I think you get this code, which allows you to log in on any of your devices. So now that I'm logged in on that free plan, I get myself one room. And of course, I've given it a title. And what's cool is when you get set up, you can choose whether to lock it or just have it open. And the issue with that is if somebody types in your URL, they'll be able to join instantly and you'll get an unwanted visitor. So they're recommending definitely to lock it before you start up. So as you can see here, you get access to your room. You can go to your room. What I noticed as well is there's actually no prompt to download a desktop application. There's a browser version, but I've yet to see a Mac version there. But as you can see, this is the landing page that you get met with. You can see here that obviously you've got your meeting URL, you've got the ability to change, turn off your camera, mute yourself, and even go into settings and change all the regular stuff that you would. So you can always skip this so that every time you join the meeting as yourself, it automatically goes in without you having to pre-check your details. And once you've joined, it's a very nice, attractive layout. I actually used this a couple of months ago with a designer that I was talking to, and I actually enjoyed the visual aesthetic of it. So you can see here that you've got the camera. You can turn that on and off. And as you can see, a nice little sort of emoji or picture of myself comes up there. I can share the screen, and I can choose any of the application windows that I have open, or the Chrome tab, which is really easy to access. And I can even record as well, but that again is a pro feature and something that I probably won't be doing if this is just for one-to-one meetings. So what's nice here is you can start a chat on this right-hand side. You can see who's in the room and who's been invited, which is very cool, and also access the people and naturally administrate them. Now up in the top right-hand corner, you can hide the toolbars, which is the bottom area, but then you can access any of the advanced or basic device settings, including the room size, which in this plan, we're currently limited up to 4. And now, as I said, the users have to knock before they enter a locked room. So let's demonstrate what that looks like. Okay folks, so it looks like I've got a one person request on this, and naturally I can let them in or I can see who it is. And what that does is it takes a snapshot of the person who is doing the video stream just before. So that's like the latest picture of them, and it looks like someone is joining, so I'll let them in. You can respond as well. You can put them on hold or reject them, and you can let them in. So this is what the conversation looks like. Just so you know, this individual is using the iOS version of the application, which once downloaded, all you have to do is actually just press join existing room. And it's very neat because that's all you have to do, so that person doesn't necessarily have to sign into their own account. They can actually just join and instantaneously become part of the meeting. Okay, so what's great is I can have up to 4 people per room, and there doesn't seem to be a known limit to how long a meeting can go on, but it seems fairly easy to use. As you can see, you can have a conversation with someone if they are a guest, and it seems fairly easy even if they have a web browser version to be able to get an invite and just join the meeting. So overall folks, I'm fairly impressed with the way this works, and I'm actually considering whilst checking it out to actually use this as my own default way to create meeting rooms and just start a regular meeting room. Obviously I don't necessarily need to upgrade to the Pro, but there is that if I did want to have meetings that are larger than 4, and also the ability to record, which I tend to do occasionally. And I noticed the consistency of the meeting to be fairly good. I mean, the individual is still here, probably just in the other room. But overall, it's not too bad. Now, they do have a business plan, which is set out for up to 50 people, and that is a pricier one. It's $59.99 per month, so it's going to be a little bit steeper and naturally come with more administration bonuses and also some more features. So overall, I think this is a fairly good way to have more suitable one-to-one meetings. And also, I think it's much better for freelancers, designers, creators, for one-to-one meetings than necessarily Zoom is. I quite like the way that the invite works, and I quite like the way that you can just get started on a meeting, and it seems a lot more friendlier and a lot more easier to use. Now, the one thing I'd say is I'm not a security expert, so I don't know all of the security details, so I will include the security FAQs below and anything else I find whilst I'm digging, whilst I'm editing. So folks, a big thank you. Hopefully you found this review of Whereby useful. Please do let me know in the description below whether you'll be using an application like this. Thank you to my helpful assistant, and I will talk to you all very soon. Cheers everyone, bye.